Well, Johnny, I think it was 20-4 when I got the key in the front door, and then about 5-ish when I got to bed. How was it for you the other night?
Pretty similar, to be honest. Yeah, I got home about 4:15, I think. So obviously it's a late one. I think some of the boys probably would have been even later. So yeah, long way to go to come back, obviously, with nothing. But focus has had to be on recovery because of that journey and obviously the time that we got back. So we had Wednesday off. He was back in Thursday, but obviously very light. Those boys that played, boys that didn't play, done a little bit more, and then we was doing a lot of match prep today. So recovered well, dusted ourselves down, and we're good to go for tomorrow.
When you've recovered, like on a Wednesday, are you able to get sort of what analysis work done, basically?
Yeah. So obviously get to bed late, so you're up quite late, but then just do all the video work really for watch the game back, and then obviously start turning the attentions to the next one, which is obviously Morecambe this time around. So spent Wednesday and Thursday watching them and just putting together the plan of what we're going to try and do, and then obviously implementing that on the grass today.
You said Accrington, of course, was a punch on the nose for the lads. Have they come out fighting since on the training ground?
Yeah, they have. It was a shame, really, because it was I felt like there was nothing in the game. They scored two worldy goals, really, great strikes. And had very little else as far as chances, and we've had some, well, not loads, but a couple of really good ones that we should have taken, and we probably should be coming away with something. And I think if you come away from there with a point, you always call that a good point at Hackey. So yeah, a bit of a shame, but certainly didn't go there and disgrace ourselves and get outplayed. So punch on the nose, like I said, after the game. But yeah, you know, there's no fallout. We recovered well, we go again, and obviously a great game for us to look forward to at home.
Absolutely. You said about learning from past performances. What did you learn from the last time we faced Morecambe?
Yeah, well, again, another game that I look back on and feel sort of opportunity missed, really. I think we was by far the dominant team in the first half of that game, and then we had a sort of a mad 10, 15 minute period, if I remember rightly, where the game got away from us, and we rallied again and came back strong, but it was too little too late. So we've learnt the lessons that you know, if you're not at it for 90 minutes and you don't get it quite right, you can come unstuck against any team in this league, and they've got good players, I know that, they're on good form. So I don't look back at the previous game too much. What I've done is obviously look at what they've done recently and what we've done recently, and yeah, and that's how we'll prep, knowing that, like always, if you don't do your the proper work, and if you don't get it right, you can get beat. But likewise, we feel like, especially at home recently with the form and the way things have been going, we fancy ourselves against anyone.
Just a quick glance at the table as well, and you see the playoff positions, and there's going to be many changes between now and the end of the season, isn't there? It's very tight.
It's so tight, yeah. I think we're 1 point outside, but you know, only a few points separate, probably eight teams, something like that. So it's going to be that team that puts a run together, I think, that's going to get that, you know, final couple of places. So we've got to be that team. We've got to try and have a bit more consistency about us. We are in decent form. We've had a little setback midweek, but I think we're playing well, and I think we're picking up points regularly. So that's what we've got to keep trying to do, to keep ourselves in that hunt. If we can put three or four wins together, then you find yourself right amongst it. So that's what we have to aim to do. Every team's going to be sat there saying the same thing, including tomorrow's opponents. So it's important that we get it right, and we get it right soon.
Team news, you've started to dip Jake Reeves in and out of training, as you said, yeah?
Yeah, Skip's sort of got, yeah, just dipped back in and out just the last couple of days. So the game will probably come too soon for him Saturday. Been out too long, really, to only have one training session. So, but he feels good. Temptation is to sling him straight back in because of, you know, the type of lad that he is, character and what he brings to the team. So, but at the same time, don't want to lose him for any longer, you know. He's an important player for us. So, especially with the schedule coming up, I think we have to be smart about it. But he's ready to go. He wants to be back involved as soon as possible. So perhaps look at Tuesday or the following Saturday to get him back involved.
And Josh Neuville starts putting those hard yards with Chris McConnell.
Yeah, he's getting there as well, Josh. He's a little bit further behind Reevesy, but not far. They've done a lot of their rehab together, so them two, they're building it up. I think we'll sort of start dipping Josh in and out of training next week. We want him back. I think hopefully we can get him back for the Doncaster game next weekend. But again, with how long he's been out, just got to be careful with it. But he's progressing really well.
Any further significant team news to report ahead of tomorrow?
No, everyone came out of the game all right. Tired boys, obviously, you know, with the exertions that we put in and the travel and how late we got back. But everyone's recovered really well and desperate to be involved on Saturday.
A couple of young lads who've done really well out on loan, Paris Locke, Ben Mason, they've picked up injuries recently. How are they?
Yeah, they just had little knocks, so I'm not too sure the extent of Ben's one. Paris actually done it back here training with us because he comes back and trains a couple of days a week with us and then obviously goes and trains with his club that he's on loan at. So, yeah, he's come back. He was involved in one of our sessions and pulled his groin, unfortunately, so he's going to miss a few weeks, but I'm told it's not too bad.
As for tomorrow, though, more from the visitors, and everyone's looking forward to another good game down at Plough.
Yeah, we've loved being there recently this season. I think our form's been really good, certainly of late. We won 6 out of the last 7, something like that at home. So it's strong form, but we need to carry it on. I think 9 of our last 15 are at home. So we've got more at home than we have away. And our form's been really good. So we need to make that count. We need to carry that on. If we can carry that on and be hard to beat there first and foremost and pick up points, then I think that gives us a good chance. It's a tough game tomorrow. Morecambe are good. I've seen a lot of them recently and they're one of the form teams in the division, so just because of the table and where they are, you know, they're in and around us, so it's an important game as far as that's concerned, but you know, we won't take them lightly at all. They're a very good team.
Brilliant. Thanks for your time, Johnny.
Cheers, Rob.